In our last episode, we did some cool stuff. We wandered around in an ice cave, got a rock that made us acquire an airship. Somehow, we gave the rat's tail to Bahamut, who decided in exchange for it, he's gonna make our classes more powerful for some reason. And then we found a new town. We grabbed some new equipment and some new spells. And now we are moving on to the next part of our journey, which, obscurely enough, happens in this little patch of desert, where you're supposed to know that there's a caravan, where a guy with a fairy and a bottle is. So yeah, here's the caravan. Let's do this. Hey, dude. Cool, I'll buy that. It's actually almost all of my money. Awesome. Oh, now he sells other stuff. That's cool. That's interesting. He sells stat-increasing potions, which I am not going to buy because they are unreliable. And what I mean by unreliable is temporary. So unless I'm in a really big, like, tight spot where it's going to benefit me quite a bit to have just a little bit of extra MP or HP or whatever, it doesn't seem worth it. Also, they're pretty expensive, and I'm almost out of money again. Let's take a look at a couple of new enemies we've run into in the desert. Got the desert Beretta, which looks like a scaly toad dog monster and has nothing to do with a gun. Seems pretty cool. He's pretty strong. He's one of the stronger enemies that I've come across so far. The Wyrvin, who is very less strong, much less strong, and resistant to quake, of course, because he's a flying enemy. So now we've got our fairy in a bottle, which may or may not be a nod to the Legend of Zelda series, where you can capture fairies in bottles, and they will recover your health automatically when you die. I'm not sure about that, but could be. And we're gonna go figure out what we do with it. There's a guy in the new town, Gaia, I believe it's called, that says something about a fairy being able to call forth something from, like, call forth something from a special mineral, if I'm remembering correctly. Only fairies can do it. Let's find that guy. Where is he? Oh! The fairy just left. I just lost my fairy. Which, I mean, if it could leave at any point, why is it still in the bottle? I don't know. Oxiao. Gushes from the bottom of our spring. Oh, okay. So the fairy is gonna go bring the Oxiao out of the spring. Which is somewhere. Hopefully somewhere in the town. It went off this way, so my guess is the spring must be somewhere this way too, right? That makes a fair amount of sense. However, it doesn't look like it is, so we're just gonna wander around this town till we find something that, looks like a spring. And is not the exit of the village. That would be cool. Spring. Is it up here? And this is the item shop. Maybe it's up here. Maybe if I keep on following this path, I'll find a spring. This is the church. Nothing springing about it. Here's a spring we need. Oh, I saw some water up here. Maybe this is the spring. God, what is bizarrely convoluted map configuration? Okay. Yes. Well, I mean, I kind of did. I bought you, and then you flew out of the bottle, but no problem. I guess. I don't know what I'm going to do with that, but sure. Why not? It's an objective. Oxyale. Air will flow out of that water for as long as you have it. It'll never run out of air, so you can use it to stay underwater as long as you like. Okay. Strange green gushes. Okay, so that's cool. I can breathe underwater indefinitely, which no doubt is helpful to me for some reason. I have no idea why that would possibly be helpful. I have not yet found any underwater dungeons. Nah, vague clues. Let's look. Gaia Cavern? Caravan. Crescent Lake would be good if I'd be able to. I really wish that they didn't organize these alphabetically and instead organized them by their location. That would be really cool. Sage's Cave, Chaos Shrine, so I'm thinking that we're kind of on our own. Let's see. These are all dragon caves. The only thing interesting in dragon caves are dragons. And that's it, as far as I know. Oh, that and Bahamut. He's in a dragon cave. He's really cool. Let me see here. Where could I possibly be going next? I found a really cool tower in the middle of this desert. And it has similar enemies, which leads me to think that I should be doing something with it. Right? It's got the desert Berettas. But I can't go into it. I can't actually do anything with it. Which is a little bit weird. Allosaurus. Also, dinosaurs. Anything in this game. So that's odd. Particularly odd, I think. There was a waterfall. Where's that waterfall? All the way up here. Can I land? I cannot land here. Oh, you gotta be. Okay, cool. So, I'm gonna see if I can land and maybe go underneath the waterfall. I'm really kind of reaching here, though. I have no idea if this is the right thing to do. I'm gonna save my game. Actually, I think we'll probably take a nap also, just to be safe. Alright, let's see if this is a thing. Super easy enemies, but what's that over there? Is that a town we've been to? That's not Crescent Lake. Is it Gaia? No. That might be. No. I have no idea what that town is. Might be something to check out. We're fighting incredibly easy enemies over here, but that could just be because of the region. Aha! The Waterfall Cavern. This is a place. Might even be the place we're supposed to be. Who knows? I mean, it took us a bit of a logical leap. My friends the bats are here, so that's a good sign. What do we have enemy-wise? We have mummies and king mummies, which are not particularly impressive for where we are. However, they are slightly more current than the enemies we were fighting in the lake. Here's the clay golem, so he's a more current enemy. This very well may be the right direction. Nightmare. Oh, he gets darkness. That's cool. Cool for him. I don't have any eye drops. Blinda. Where are you, Blinda? What? Oh! Blind is an pervasive status effect. What am I even doing? Okay. Lots of them. Might be a little bit over-leveled for this area, I guess. I did put the time into, I should be up in my next magic level pretty soon. That's exciting. Did put the time into classing up, which, like I said, is, as far as I know, a completely optional thing. So you don't actually have to do that. They're not even gaining MP at a very fast rate. I wonder... So my... I mean, cure is 3. So at the most, and blind... Blinda is 3. At the very most, they could cast one first level spell. He can cast 2 now. If they increase at a rate of 3 every time, that still doesn't give you a very big MP pool at all by the time you hit the end of the game. So that's... I mean, that's kind of how that works. That's really unfortunate. I wonder why they didn't try and even that out a little bit in the port. Because it just seems kind of pointless now. Hyrolisks, which I guess are like basilisks only with fire, and also they're birds. Lots of kingdom mummies. These are all super weak enemies, which is kind of surprising. I was kind of thinking that I would come across something a little bit stronger. Am I fighting this robot now? No. Boom. Bye-bye. Hey, robot. What's up? You have been waiting. Take this cube. TM, man. Flying Fortress, please. So... So there's a robot. There's a robot in the bottom of this waterfall cave, right? His only purpose is to wait for you and then give you a ribbon. That's pretty big. Give you a cube that teleports you to another place? That seems odd. Seems a little bit odd to me. Now he doesn't talk anymore. And I'm forced to fight Moon Counter every time I touch this square. But oh well. Because progress is progress, and we're happy about progress. So the cast blink when used, that's cool. It's also better than my ice brand. So defender it is. What was the other? Oh, wizard staff. Wizard staff sucks. But it casts Confuse when I use it as an item, which is cool. I'm inclined to say that it affects my magic in some way, but I guess I could check. Let's look at his stats. Intelligence, maybe? Is at 41 with the mage's staff, or wizard staff. With the cat claws, it's still at 41. So staffs don't affect my magic stats at all. Oh, and the ribbon. That's the other thing. Ribbons are incredibly big. Very late game acquisitions in almost every Final Fantasy game, I believe. Oh, it's a head accessory. Some games only women can use them. Some games everybody can use them. Ribbons make you immune to all status effects ever, which is great. It's incredibly great. Very useful, especially in Battle for Mojo in Final Fantasy VII, which I've never ever been able to get past. So that's cool. Found a ribbon. Found the Defender, which is also going to be a sword and or great sword that's going to be reoccurrent in our Final Fantasy adventures. Usually also a sort of later game acquisition. I hope they say something more than blah 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 flying fortress. Maybe they'll show us the flying fortress, like, coming up out of the ground. Have a little nifty cutscene or something. That would be cool and useful. Although, if it's a flying fortress, why wouldn't I just be able to park my airship on it? I guess would be my question, but that is maybe a silly question. A town that I haven't been to yet. Oh, we've got wyverns over here. This is the town of Onrak. Onrak. Hey, what's up? That's... boy. Pretty cool that you have legs. Good job. Oh, okay. So if you'd happen to come to this town, I guess you would know that the caravan is there. And that other guy would have told you that the fairy in the bottle sold to the caravan. So, okay. What's the sunken shrine? Sky people use the language called Lufinian. Oh. Une is a doctor that we met in Earth Place. Totally said his name was Une. I do have Oxyale. Where are you going? What are you doing? Why are you making that noise? Cope. Sure. Oh. Okay, so he would tell you about the waterfall, I guess, if you didn't find it by yourself. Ornak. Okay, so he's telling you about the shrine. Before I do that, gonna definitely. Why is everyone in this town talking about legs? Seems pretty odd. Underhill Thelma. Oh, so that's more caravan stuff. I don't know, but you're pirates, so my guess is you pillage and kill people. If I remember correctly, 200 years ago is when the water elemental fiend appeared. So that sort of syncs up correctly. Yes, I in fact have Oxyale. Oh. Okay. Another well joke. Okay. Item shop. So it looks like this place just has an item shop and a magic shop. The magic shop may very well have our missing level 7 spells. Attack and accuracy. I honestly don't see either of these spells being particularly useful. He's not an attacker, unless it means magic attack, in which case that's cool. But why would it be accuracy as well? Because magic doesn't have accuracy, as far as I know. Defense against death. God, that would be good. I think I'm going to take this. I think it'll be useful later on in the game. Or actually, right now in the game. I'm going to leave that... Oh, what? Dragon? That's cool. I'm going to leave that last slot open and get in the barrel. Do it. That last spot, I think I'm going to keep open. Just on the off chance I find one or the other special ability or thing to be more useful. And this is a sweet little transition. So, actually, really quick, let's look at this warp cube made of multi-hued substance. So, I guess I'm doing something in the shrine with it. Sahagin Prince, he's a new guy. I don't think we've seen white sharks either. I'm gonna go ahead and make a wild guess that most of these enemies are gonna be weak against thunder. Also, really easy to kill. It's not predicting that. Cool. Well, that'll make things easier then. And since these chests are stocked with a wicked amount of gil, I will probably never have to grind again. Oh! Oh, so let's look at our new friends. Allosaurus. We found him in the desert. He has a strength tonic. That's cool, if he ever drops it. We've got our Sahagin Prince. Yes, weak against lightning. White Shark drops a worm killer. And is also weak against lightning. Very good. That all seems to line up. Sea Snakes. Some other things. So Sea Snake is just a cooler version of our favorite snake enemies with the underwater weaknesses and resistances. Sea Scorpion, also same. Sea Troll, who's just weak against lightning and resistant to quake. Not fire though, because he's regaining, or he retains his troll stuff. Although he's not weak against it, but he's not resistant either. Oh, what the fuck was that terrible thing? Water Naga. Creepy. Very creepy. Same underwater weaknesses and whatnot. Cool. Okay, so that seems to be... Oh, there's another stairs up. Multiple stairs always makes me suspicious. Oh, well... Oh, God. Look at all these Sahagins. Why not blast them all with a Thundara? Splat. It's not even my most powerful thunder spell. How about that? I guess they're gaining MP a little bit faster than I thought. But I'm still not wholly convinced that... Oh, ooh, what was that? Ah, damn it. A water elemental. Interesting. Weak against ice. Double interesting. Unless I guess you're thinking, or we're thinking that ice freezes a water elemental, which I guess I could get behind. Is interesting and worth noting that, where are they? Fire elementals, right? And where was the earth elemental, right? Both share a sprite, and they're just recolored versions of each other, while the water elemental is completely different. So that's interesting. I think that's interesting. This... Oh, I see. This is a stairs going down. While the other one, the sunken shrine, was a stairway going up. Which is actually also pretty interesting. The sunken shrine fourth floor. Ghosts, which I believe we've already run into. They're just stronger versions of our other... Oh, maybe not. Ghosts might be new. Yep. Stronger versions of our undead enemies that are not skeletons. So I like that underwater overlay effect. That's nice. Treasure chest. This is undoubtedly going to be the most annoying fight I ever had to fight. Zap. 20 gil, wow. Thanks, Squaresoft. That's so useful. Looks like it's gonna be a pretty big area. Oh, that was a new thing. Pretty big area to explore too. Deep eyes. Deep eyes. I hate this battle. It's not even hard. It's just annoying. That's all it is it's just simply annoying. I think one of my things about this level I'm starting to find is that it's big and the encounters are quite often. We found another. Oh, this is a mage's staff that uses Fyra. That's cool. I'm a big fan of secondary item effects. I'm actually. I think it's a really cool thing that they kind of dropped from the Final Fantasy series. I want to say around 5 or 6. But it gives you a reason to hold on to items. Also, it gives your mages something to do when you run out of MP, if you happen to run out of MP. Which is really important because in this game, the cast Diara when used. That's also super cool. In this game, ethers are fairly affordable. Almost every other Final Fantasy game, except for maybe the remakes that we'll be playing of the first four. Ethers are hellaciously expensive, like way too expensive. And so you almost never use them because they're valuable, and then when you do, you can almost never replenish them. This is really Diamond armor. Sweet. Better than ice armor? Oh, yeah. Awesome. You are better than ice armor as well. You may have noticed that I decided to give the ribbon to my white mage. I generally feel like, in terms of keeping people alive and who's the most important to keep alive, white mage always is right at the top of your list, because the white mage is the person that's going to be able to heal people and bring people back to life, more importantly, for free. And they can also almost always cure other status effects. So, you want to make sure that you keep your white mage alive so that they can keep your other party members alive, essentially. So that's why she gets the ribbon. There's another stairway going up. I don't actually know if I'm supposed to be going down or up, so I'm just, I guess, kind of winging it. Oh, there's a mermaid over there. I'm supposed to be saving her. Ah, there's another mermaid. Oh. I think the ship has sailed on that already. I think you've already sunk. That's why my white mage always gets upgrades armor-wise first. So. Have they? Well, okay. Congratulations. I don't know what you're praying to. Mermaid god or something? Oh no. I do hope that as well. I have oxygenated booze. Diamond gloves. Wow. All sorts of diamond. What? Oh, I got the Rosetta Stone. Cool. That is definitely a key item that I will need. Cool, so you get all diamond out then. Except not for that. Actually. That's worse. It's just straight up worse. That's odd, but okay. At least I have a better thing, right? This is such a big map. I kind of wish that I had a local map for this game. That'd be really cool. One of the things that I appreciate very much about DS port of, well, I think it's in Final Fantasy IV. I didn't actually play that one, but the DS port and remake of 3 is that they give you a local map for each of the regular maps that you encounter. I think that's an incredible idea, especially if you're going to construct your dungeons to look incredibly samey. Yes. And kind of be labyrinthian in their construction, then unless you're just really out to piss people off, like, it seems to behoove you to give your adventurers a way of mitigating that. Even if it was an item that you had to buy, like, there was a reoccurring cartographer NPC that just had a place in every town, and you could always buy another map from him. That would be cool. In fact, I'm pretty sure there are games that handle it that way. And that way, like, obviously it's not important, and you don't even have to use it if you don't want to. However, if you do get annoyed by wandering around the same cave for like 5 hours, then you can buy the map and be like, okay, get the fuck out of here, because I know where I'm going. I am going to go ahead and end the recording here, I think. I'm going to get out of the water shrine and save, and then we'll probably do a part two episode going down in the water shrine instead of progressing upwards, and seeing if I can't figure out something else to do here. So, yeah. Where some of these parasites have. I swear to God, something used blink. Maybe I'm just crazy. Maybe I am. Oh, we can't actually use it for the menu. I guess that makes sense. That would be a little bit overpowered. Now everything is even weaker than it was. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and cut the recording here, and we'll actually call this the end of the episode. And then when we pick up next week, we will do part two of the watery shrine place, and we will go down in the shrine instead of progressing upwards. And hopefully we'll make some progress there. So thanks for joining me, and we'll see you back around next episode. Bye!